Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night, depending on what time you're watching this next episode, from me, Avomance. And today, we're going to build a house. And the first thing you got to do when you build a house is you got to find out, look how that thing in the background disappears and reappears and disappears and reappears. It's like it's going into some strange other world. Anyway, and I like that kind of overhanging rocky thing with trees on in the background. Anyway, enough of that. Anyway, I'm getting distracted. Stop getting distracted. Look the other way. That's better. Right, I'm going to build a house. The first thing you need when you build a house is a nice area to build it in. So I've got this little nice area. It's near some nice stuff. It's got a nice little pond. It's by the river. It's got everything you could want for a nice little house. So we are going to crack right on. First thing I've done is to mark out my territory, my pitch. Now that looks like quite a weird and nebulous wobbly shape, and it sort of is, but it's made up of odd numbers. If you go from the far left to the far right, there are 21 blocks in the middle of those. If you go from the far right to the nearly far left, the one kind of around the almost to the far left, that's 15 blocks. The side is 9. The back is 7, the side is 7. These are all odd numbers, and that is why it is going to work. Let's crack on. First things first, we are going to put our wood tower. So we're going to get our block of wood, and I always like to use wood for this. And we're going to go 5 high. Now, normally we'd go kind of 3 or 4, but this one we're going to go 5 high because it is just ever so slightly bigger than a lot of our other builds. Whoops, don't fall over though. So make sure you've got 5 high on each of these, and that is going to be the frame upon which we start to build the rest of the house. And it's really critical that we do it equally, except for these front two, which we're going to ignore completely for now. So there we go. So that's 5 high posts. Now next, inside these outer posts, we're going to build a 5 high stone brick tower as well. So you get 5 high like that on these outer bricks here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, whoop, and 5, and then again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this is going to be effectively the frame of the build. So what we're going to be putting in here, we're going to put a block there, a block there, and a block there, a block there, a block there, and a block there. We're going to do exactly the same here. And what that will do is that will kind of create almost like an in-pinning of these beams. It will kind of form the inner edge of the house, if you like. So we're going to again do the same up here, 5 high, in there, in there, in there. So you can see that front wall has got a bit of an underpin going right there. We're going to do the same on this one and on this side as well, and one there, there, and there. So we're creating kind of E's. These are loads of letter E's backwards and forwards. You can see that it's dead easy. Easy. Oh, I'm an absolute genius. I'm a comedy genius. That is not in the right place. There, and there. So you can see we've got another E there. We're going to do exactly the same inside here. 5 that way. We need to come in there, there, and there. There, there, and there. Again on this side. Like that. So what we've got now on those pillars, we've got E shapes. Now on this side here, this is a little bit, I guess you could call it slightly different, in that it needs to kind of match up, but we still need to create the E in that way. We've not got an E going in that direction, coming this direction. That makes sense. So no matching E here, if you like, but we have got an E going out there, and they're going to form the corners of our building. Just check that we've not missed any. No, we have not. And then here in the front, we're going to put 3 high. 1, 2, and 3. And then another 1, 2, and 3. Because that is going to become a shorter gable end than the rest of it. And what we're going to end up doing here is this is going to come out and create a kind of an L shape for the wall. But we don't want to make it look, you know, too stone bricky, otherwise we'll have too much stone bricks and not enough of the other textures. So that is what we're going to do next, some other textures. So anybody that's watched any of my other house builds will know that this is the point which I like to do my roof, but I'm not going to do that today. I'm going to do some of the other walls. And that's because we kind of need the guidance for this slightly odd shape that we've created here. It's a very, very different shape, as you can see. And we don't want to be doing the roof in the wrong direction. We need to make sure we've got a nice wall. So what we're going to do first is we're going to smack that sheep out of the way. And we're going to come along and just build a lower wall that is the outline of our building. And you notice we've come in one from each of these posts. That's because we want to get a little bit of depth on the wall, so as there's a just a better shape, really. So we're going to put that like that and like that. Then we're going to do that and that, but we're going to leave that as a hole because that's going to be a back door. And then we're just going to follow this shape around like this, coming along here, there, there, and there. So you can see that's how the house is actually going to look. So whilst we had quite an odd looking shape, you can see it becomes quite an interesting looking house. But what we want to do is we want to build up these walls with different types of texture, and we also want to be catering for windows. So if I want to get my windows here, I'm going to put my windows in first so I know exactly where they're going to go. So I'm going to put a row of three windows there. I'm going to put a row of a row of two windows just there. I'm going to come along here. This is going to become a three window gap at the end. Come to this side. That's going to be two. That's going to be just a single window on that side. We're going to have an equally single window on that side. We're going to have one, two, and three windows there. We can have no window here at all. And then we're going to have one, two, three windows there. So you can see the setup that we've got there for the windows. We're also going to put a window in there and there to give us a little bit of side view when we are walking down this corridor, because these both sides here are going to be a kind of a block end, if you like. So they're not going to have any windows coming out of the end here. So they need windows on the side. And then we're just going to build up around. Now we know we've already got lots of stone bricks. So what we need is other textures. So let's get rid of our stone brick there. We want to use cracked stone bricks, which are really nice, some cobblestone and some smooth stone. And what we're going to do is we're going to relatively randomly put these in. And sometimes we're going to replace these cobble bottoms that we've got here, because no one wants a cobble bottom. And we're going to replace those with these other bricks. And we're going to just fairly randomly, but not entirely randomly, we're going to be putting these in so as it creates a nice texture. And you won't really know how it's going to look until you've actually done it. So it's going to be mainly cobble with the odd bit of other stuff thrown in. So a little bit of cracks there, a little bit of cobble there. And what some people might like to do here is to do this by doing the entire wall as cobble and then replacing some of the other bricks. But I'm going to try and be clever and do it another way, because I can. And then we're going to put another cobble there, definitely cobble there and there. We're going to put some cracked stone bricks there. We're going to put some smooth stone. No, that's glass. We're going to put some smooth stone there and some smooth stone there. So you can see we've created that wall and it looks all right. And what we are going to do, we're actually going to put some smooth stone in there as well. This is all going to be brick. So let's get that brick in there now. That's going to be brick. That's going to be brick. And then we can do exactly the same on all of these other walls, doing some random kind of texturing and keeping these E shapes on each end. So I'll be back when I've done that. So there you've got it. We've got a nice stone clad or stone walled house there with some wooden beams just to support it. So we're very happy with the way that looks. But now we need to, what you might think is a little bit daft, and cover up the top parts, the top row along here like this. Now it doesn't matter that we've covered it out, because what's important is we're going to be able to see it from the inside. And remember that every build, it's not just about what's on the outside, it's what's on the inside that counts. Everybody tells you that, you should know that by now. It's what's on the inside that counts. And then we're going to come along it. Oh, look what I've done here. I've now forgotten to create the necessary gappage at the top. I've just left it completely open. Let's put that there like that. There we go. So we've got that across there. Then we're going to put the wood again across the top there. Do it again here. Bring it out like that, all the way across and along, because this will give us the necessary frame we need to be able to put the roof structure on much happier. It will look much better when we do it once we've got these cross beams on. And then we need to bring this cross beam all the way along the top, make sure that it faces the right way, coming up and across like that. We're going to do something there in a moment, and we're going to come along and bring that across like that there, and then we've got all of the cross beams perfectly like that. And what we're going to do is we're going to decide where do we want our kind of apexes, our gable ends to go. And I would argue that you need to look at what is the longest length you've got on your house, and that is where the gable end is going to go. And anywhere you've got an indentation, you need a slightly different gable end. So here we've got this bit, so this needs to be one gable end, but here from there across, that needs to be another gable end. And I know it's slightly offset, but that doesn't matter, we can still do it really quite nicely. So I'm going to start by using, again, we're going to use stone brick. Now traditionally I've always used cobble to do this, but this time we're going to go just a little bit wild and we're going to use stone bricks, and we're going to come out like that. And this gable end is just going to be a very standard apex. It's going to be a triangle. We're not going to have any wobblies on it. It's going to be just completely normal. So just backwards and forwards, making your gable end look just like that. And then exactly the same on the other side. I'm going to come out and I'm going to go backwards and forwards until we've got a nice looking, no, not like that, a nice looking A shape that is nice and symmetrical on the side of our house. I'm just going to come up like that, and then we're going to do exactly the same there. And we should find, because we've got an odd number, we should find we've got a gap. And in the front of that, we're going to do an upside down step like that. So you can see there, one gable end looks really, really quite nice. And then here, on this one, we're going to do another gable end, but this one we're going to do ever so slightly differently. We're still going to start in the same way. We're going to come out here, and we're going to come up like that, and we're going to go up there, and we're going to come out like that. But then we're going to get stone bricks, and then we're going to get stone brick steps, and we're going to come up, and then we're going to get stone brick steps again, come backwards like that. Then we're going to get stone bricks and go on top. You can see we're forming a sharper end, and now we've got some rain. That's what everybody needs in their life. Not, let me just get rid of that rain. It might not even let me do it. Yes, it will. Okay, so we got rid of the rain, and we're going to put another stone block there like that. And you can see what we're doing, we're just creating a nice sharp point. Now obviously we need this gable to match on this side, and we're one off, but that's okay, because what we're going to do is we're going to make a wider gable on this side, and it is going to work. I know you'll say, Avo, that's going to look daft, but trust me, it won't look daft, it will look all right. So we've got to just make sure that we're matching it up. So when we're there, we are coming across, and then we need to put another one there. Is that right, or have I done? So we've got, hang on, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yep, I thought I was right. I just wanted to check. It's always good just to make sure. Then we're going to have a block there, then a stair, then an upside down stair, and a block, and then a stair, upside down stair, and a block. No, that's upside down stair, please, Avomance, and a block there. So you can see, so what we're doing here is we're starting to build up a sharper gable end, and that will mean when we flow this other roof into it, it will flow into part of that roof, but it won't look like it's completely, you know, engulfed by the roof. So I'm just going to carry on doing this, because this roof's going to be sharp almost to the top there, and there we're going to get 9, put steps like that, like that. And then we're going to start to taper it off, because what we don't want is it to become too high. Otherwise, it will just look a little bit like a witch's hut, frankly. So we're just going to bring it round, and we're going to end up with, again, exactly like the other one, a gap in the middle where we're going to put upside down stairs like that. So you can see we've got a really nice shape, and this is slightly offset, and we'll run into it beautifully like that. Then on this side, we're going to do exactly the same, and in this way, this is offset again, you can see, so it comes in and it's offset. So here we're going to do another just flat gable end like this that is just going to be stairs going backwards and forwards like this. So I'm going to carry on doing this, and when I've finished, I'll be back. So we have got our frame, and I know you're thinking, Avo, that is a really tall roof you've got in the middle there. What are you going to do with it? Well, you're just going to have to keep watching and waiting and see, weren't you? Now, we're not going to put any more struts other than what I have done on this side, which was acting as a guide for me along that bit. But what we are going to do now is we're going to slap a little bit of flooring in it. Now, I'm going to be using this brown terracotta because it makes for quite a nice rustic floor. And we're literally just going to go away weather. Weather clear. Oh, do it right. There we go. So that gets rid of that weather. We have to put one of these weather commands on this world, I think, just to stop the weather keeping changing. But we're just going to carry on, get this flooring all coated for. I know it looks a little bit like a mud floor, and that's all right. We actually don't mind it looking a little bit like a mud floor. We're going to come along, just fill it all in. So let's crack on. So there we've got it. We've got a nice brown floor inside, which works really well. Look at the beautiful contrast with the grey stone. We like that a lot. We've come along this corridor, but we've not done that outer one. And we have done this outer one here, so you can see where the floor stops. And now what we're going to try and do is we're going to try to start to frame up this roof a little bit. And we're going to start with this part. And the reason we're going to start with this part is because that is going to merge into this roof a little bit. We're going to use spruce wood stairs. And we're just going to run these stairs into the wall, literally into the wall. So you've got to come out, you've got to just fiddle about and get it inside that wall there like that. That's great. And then come along, do exactly the same on the other side like that. And then what's going to happen is these ones will meet these posts here, and that's what we're trying to achieve, so as we can get a nice covered up feel. And then here we're going to get our, where is it, there we go, we're going to get ourselves a stone brick slab, and we're going to come along the outside matching here like that. So we've got an overhang, can you see? So we put four along, one, two, three, four. And what that does is that actually meets the end of that gable really, really quite nicely. And what we're going to do is exactly the same on all of these parts. We're going to come along. That's going to go there, and it makes that nice corner. Those stairs match up. And on this side, we're going to do the same. And there, those stairs match up. And then we're going to do exactly the same along there. And along here like this. And I'm going to carry on until I've done the entire lot. We're not going to do upside down stairs like we did with the gable, like that there. But that's not how it's going to work. We're just going to match whatever brick or block we've got here. We are going to match with the wood. So here, we're going to get a spruce wood plank and come along, because that's how the gable end kind of meets up. And then on top of that, we're going to put the stairs, because again, that is how the gable end meets up. So you've got a continuous roofage, if you like, just like that. Then we're going to do exactly the same. Where's my, there it is. So we're going to put another spruce wood block here. Now, the reason we're not doing the upside down bits is because we're creating some additional space on the interior of this roof. And the reason we want to create additional space on the interior of this roof is because we are going to create another level, and that other level is going to make it, you know, if we had the roof enclosed, it would be much kind of more locked in, much less room. We wouldn't be able to have as much space to play with. We wouldn't have these nice kind of square walls on the interior, but that we've got those at the moment. So I've just lobbed my stairs away. Let's pick those stairs back up again, and we're just going to carry on, and I'm going to put the roof in exactly as I've described here. I've lobbed that away again. I do like lobbing that away. And we're going to carry on until we're finished. So we've got some roofage on there, and I agree with you, that looks like one big expanse of wood. Don't you worry about that, because we're going to do something that is going to stop it looking like a big expanse of wood very, very shortly. What we're going to do first, however, is we are going to venture inside through the door that we haven't actually put in there yet. Now, first thing I'm going to do, I'm just going to put some light down, not because I'm trying to keep mobs away, because I'm being creative, that's not a major problem, but simply so as I can see what the blooming heck I am doing, because that is a fairly critical part of the build. Now, you need to decide You've got quite a lot of kind of sprucey looking stuff here. What do you want to have your floor made out of? Now, I quite like the idea of having this done in oak planks. So where's my oak planks? My oak planks right there. Let's put my oak planks in, and I'm going to put them in at a level that gives us plenty of space and head height. So I'm going to suggest we're going to go up 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then on the top of that fourth one, which gives us 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 and a half blocks, we're going to put in our floor like this, which gives us a full block on the top, which means anything that we land or we put on this half slab is actually going to be placed on the floor and isn't going to be placed kind of floating in the air like some anti-gravity weird bed thing, which nobody needs in their life, frankly. We don't want anti-gravity. Anti-gravity is not something that Minecraft requires. And we're going to just carry on doing this, keeping a whole block open on the top like this, and we're going to fill in everything bar the center section on here. There we go, so like that. I'm going to come along exactly the same way, everything bar that center section. And yeah, we've got a bit of rogue wallage here, and that's all right. We don't mind having that rogue wallage. It is meant to be there. So this is going to be our upstairs, and what we do want to create on this upstairs is a platform across this section. So we're going to come across there like that, and then one more. So is there actually some kind of walkway that we can go along? And in fact, I think we need to come one more again like that. So there you go. So we've got a nice walkway there that we can come in and out of. Now what that means is, if we come out of this hole, this front here is a big expanse of wall right now, and that's not necessarily something we want. So we're going to create a dormer. And what a dormer is, it's like a bit of roof that comes out of the side of your roof, like here. So we're just going to take out 1, 2, 3, 4, nope, not that, put that back, 5 wide, and we're going to come up that far, I think, and just check on the outside, just to check that it's high enough. Actually, I'm going to take it out just one more. So that is going to be our and a dormer roof area. And what we're going to do is we're going to bring it out. So we're going to get our spruce wood stairs, and we're going to come out sideways from the spruce wood stairs there and there. And what that gives us is a 3 wide, you can see that 3 wide gap. And once we've got that, we're just going to create, again, that's going to come up. We just want to kind of create, that's the wrong place, you Wally. So we're going to create a kind of where it comes out, it juts out straight up. So this bit is going to go pretty much straight up. So we want to come out. In fact, I need to make it a little bit wider. That's why it won't work. There we go, that's better. Right, so let's come out a little bit wider there. That's better. Now I know what I'm doing. So we're going to come straight up like this, and we're going to create a gable arch. It's not hugely big. There, there. And just as we did with the others, like that. So that is kind of our gable archway, and we're going to create a window on that. And we then need to connect this all up on the inside. So where we've got a block here, we need to connect with block. Whoop, and I don't want to throw my block away again. Where we've got, we need to connect with block. And where we've got stairs, we need to connect with stairs. So let's connect that up. And there, and we know that that, if we then go to the side, that works. I can't quite get there. That works like that. There we go, that's what we're after. Right, I'm going to get rid of this weather once and for all. So weather clear 100,000. There we go, that weather will now be clear for 100,000 game ticks. So that's awesome, that's what we're after. That goes like that. Awesome. So then we're going to have another spruce wood plank there and there, there and there. I didn't need to come out quite as high as I thought. And then we're going to have spruce wood there. Bring that across like that. And then what we need to do, exactly the same as we did before, we're going to create kind of an outer edge like this. So get Where's it gone? There is our stone wood steps. And we're going to put stone wood steps on the outside of each of these steps that we've just added. So one there. And it will look odd for a bit, but don't worry, it won't look odd forever. We're going to put another one upside down there. 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 Okay, and then we're going to do exactly the same on the other side. Get it lined up. Where's it gone? There. There we go. That's better. There. 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 That's great. And then we're going to put an upside down step there like that. And yeah, I know it's kind of a bit wobbly underneath, but that's all right. It looks all right. And then what we're going to get is our ridge, which we can do exactly the same thing as we did before. Connect that up like that. And this is going to come out one step further on the top row. So there we go. So we've got a nice kind of dormer style window type thing coming out the side of that second floor. And that's going to just add a little bit more light into the system. So we're going to come inside again. And you can see inside that looks like that. We're going to tidy it up. It's going to look awesome. But we've got to create a way of getting up here. And I quite like having sort of staircases that come up the middle of a room. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just do one layer first. And we're going to put steps the right way around. There we go. Hang on. So I need to put a block underneath there first. I'm going to get steps the right way around and then come up under there like that. There. Dig down into the hole there like that and then like that. So that's the first bit of step. Let's just fill in that hole before someone falls down and breaks their ankle. Perfect. And then jack it away. And then we need to match it up so as it's not kind of all disjointed at the top. So that's going to be like that. And then we know that it's got to be like that. So there we go. It connects up just very nicely. And then we need to decide how wide do we want these steps. We can have them one wide. We could have them two wide. Or we could have them three wide. Me, I think I'm going to go for two wide. Because they look wide enough, I think, if you have them too wide. And you can also just add the underside like that. And you could argue, Avo, that's a little bit close to that side. And I kind of agree with you, it's fairly close, but it is okay. I think we're going to be all right on this time. And now get ourselves a little bit of fence just to stop ourselves from falling to our deaths. There and there. So that then creates a nice fenced off area at the top that will stop us dying a lot. Because you know me, I'm almost certainly going to die a lot if I do anything daft and fall off that edge. So that's great. So now, doors. Time for doors. Where's my door? I know I had some doors. Put a door on the inside of that. Come along here. Don't throw it away. Put a door on the inside. Did I not pick it up? There we go. Put a door on the inside of that. And that is then deliberately the outside, the frontage. So you can see we've got grass on there. But on the back, we've deliberately kept that as the floor. And that's just to differentiate between the back door and the front door. I think this is quite high. It looks pretty good. And we've got a nice staircase that we can go up. But now we've got to do quite a lot of tidying up. Because inside here, it doesn't look quite right. We need to finish off these gable ends, but it's got to be on the interior. How are we going to do that? Well, we're going to do it, at least to start with, a little bit like this. We're going to maintain our inner wall, this kind of ridge bit here. We're going to do something there in a minute. We're going to maintain the depth that we've achieved as a result of this roof. And we're going to bring some oakwood planks with a 3x2 window in the middle. Now, that window looks a little bit high, but again, lots of detail is going to come in later on. Let's come around the other side, and we're going to do something very, very similar. So again, along the stone edge, just to give you a guide, we're going to come along. We're going to come inside there, inside there. We want a three, a window shape. Whoops, get it in the right area. A window shape, but it's going to be smaller on this one because it is a smaller gap. And we're going to put, now we have to decide, do we want one? And actually, I'm not sure. Do we want one, do we want two? I'm going to have two high because I think that looks quite nice. So that's that gable end. Now these gable ends are a little bit more complicated because they're a bit more wobbly and a bit more kind of out there. And also, if we're not careful, it's going to look a little bit strange. But we still want to make sure that we've got a closed system. I've just noticed I've not put the roof strut on that, so I best do that first. Let's just put that there. What we're going to do is we're going to get our stone all the way. No, not there. Our stone all the way along to the end. There we go. That's much better. So we're going to go in exactly the same way. We're going to build up the end, but obviously we want to maintain the inside. So we're only going to build up the end on the outer blocks. I'll demonstrate what I mean by that. Come up. So that is an outer block. That is an outer block. That is an inner block. That's outer. That's outer. Let's just build up the wall first and we'll do the decoration on it later. On this side, exactly the same. They are all outer blocks. That is outer. There we go, like that. And just carry on building that up until you've got the block end that you're looking for. We go outside, you can see it starts to build up quite nicely. We've got quite a nice interesting shape inside there, and we'll do something here now because we can. We've got just exactly the same flat edge as we had before, so we can fill in there and there. We can come up, that creates a nice, there we go, there's my window, that creates a nice section there that can come across like that, and then we can just fill in the top like that, give ourselves a really nice open window which we can fill in with some glass. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. And then we just do the same at the other end. So we've got the basic structure of the house, but it's got no detail. In fact, it's quite bland. It's got some really nice shape. It's got some flowing lines. We've got some repetition of gables and stuff like that. And we've got a mansion house in the background. I didn't even see that. That's awesome. But we're worried about our own mansion house. But it's got no detail. As I say, we want to expand on the detail of this house. And there's a number of ways in which you can do it. And it's entirely up to you. But we both need to do the outside and the inside in terms of detail. Right now the inside is open and cold and just a little bit dark, and the outside frankly isn't really that much to write home about. So we want to be adding some details. Windows we might want to think about making bigger. For example, we could bring these out, we can put larger windows in like that. That's quite nice. We don't have to do it for all of them, but I think that looks quite good. Let's do it again for this. There you go, much nicer open window there. We can again do it here. I think it would be good like that. You know what, I'm even going to do it there as well. Let's expand it out. Let's make it ever so slightly wider. We're going to do this here. And this gives us an opportunity just to play around with the design and decide what it is we actually want to do with it. So I'm just opening this out. And this, you should do this with all your builds really. Don't be fixed. If you've done something, it doesn't mean you've got to keep it that way. I'm going to keep those two that size. I'm going to bring that open like that. I'm going to stick that open like that. Because actually, that you know what? I think that's in the wrong place. I think we're going to come along there. We're going to get a bit of cobble, which is number 3. I'm going to lose that. I'm going to put some cobble there. I'm going to put a bit more cracked stone there. So now that's slightly more separated from that wall. And I think, again, that looks just a little bit better. Then we can start to do the little bits of detail that every house requires. So for example, on the side here we're going to do just a couple of bits of trapdoor that acts for a nice frame for that window. We're going to do that here as well, do it even for the small windows. And already you can see the outside of the house is starting to look better with just that tiny little bit more detail. Now we've not come anywhere close to finishing it. We're going to leave those as they are. We're going to leave this one as it is because actually we need to do something else on that side. That roof gets in the way of being able to put kind of side shutters on it, but this one doesn't. We can put that there like that and there like that. That looks great. and another one on there. So you get the idea. So that's one way that we can put extra detail on. Now, another way we can put extra detail on is to put in some window boxes. Window boxes can come in all shapes and sizes. We could put in upside down stairs by doing that, that, and that. And then we can stick a flower pot on there. We can put a flower in the flower pot like that. So that acts like quite a nice little, it's just a windowsill, isn't it, on the outside, but it looks pretty, pretty good. And then you can also, if you wish, you can get some dirt and you can put a dirt windowsill in like that. We can get some trapdoors there on the side, on the side there. And again, we can get ourselves some plants. Go poppy, poppy, poppy. There you go. And we've got another quite nice little windowsill there. So different types of windowsills give different effects. So I'm going to carry on and do more detailing around the outside of this house. Oh, I've just noticed, look, we've not filled in the top of that door. So I'm going to get upside down steps there. I'm going to stick some upside down steps on there. And then on the inside here, we need to get the same wood that we've tipped off everything else with. Put it there, there, there. You know what? I'm going to come in like that. And then what we're actually going to do is we're going to stick a bit of glowstone in that. And that light's set up. So there we've got a little bit more detail. Not finished, but a little bit more detail. We've hung some lights off of two bits of wall with glowstone covered up with trap doors there. We've done some different types and different styles of window boxes. And what you can also do is you can combine them. So you've got kind of a combined window box and upside down step job there. That works really, really well. So what we're going to go inside now, because the inside is still really quite bland. So what we're going to do is we need to create a nice kind of open space. The first thing we want to do is we want to think, what is going to take up the most room? And we know that the most room is often taken up when we do enchanting, because you need a load of books, don't you? So we're going to get some books. We're going to put books in here, and we can go underneath the window quite happily and to the side of the window and all the way to the opening of that door. And that gives us an area right here where I'm pointing to stick in our enchanting table. And those bookshelves will then power that enchanting table absolutely beautifully. It'll work really well. You can already see those enchanted letters flowing into that book exactly as we require it. And then what you can do up here is you can get your glowstone, because these glowstones are only temporary, remember. You can get a bit of glowstone and you can put it there. That then looks all mystical and lovely, and you can close it up again with a little bit of trap doorage, and that works really, really quite nicely. We can get rid of that one for now, because what we are going to do is we're going to put in some more permanent glowstone up there, and we're going to again trap doorage that up. And that works quite nicely. Or alternatively, if you wish, you can get yourself some fence and stick it in like that and create like a standard lamp. But for me personally, I prefer the old trapdoor. I just think it looks really, really quite nice. You can't put a bit of trapdoor on the top, unfortunately, because this is only half a slab's gap, and that hole is being taken up by the slab there. And then we need to think about, what else do we want to fit in? Do we want this to be a functional area? Do we want it to be just aesthetic and just pretend like it's a kitchen with a working oven and that kind of thing? Me, aesthetic is great, but I prefer functional. So what we want is we want something here that is going to allow us to continue doing our magics. And magic is all about potions and enchanting. So what we're going to do here is we're going to get a whole row of three. I'm going to change that up so as it looks nicer by putting cobble in like that. I'm going to get a bucket of water. In fact, I'm going to get two buckets of water, one there and one there. And then I'm going to get some chests, two chests, one there, one there. That will then only allow me to take water from that middle part right there, which then means that when I do my brewing, where I put my brewing stand there, it's ideally suited. I can open both of those chests, and away we go. So that is now our magical area, and I think that looks really, really quite nice. We're going to extend more light because we're not nearly lit enough by putting, again, exactly the same way. There and there. That gives us plenty of light at this end of the room. And then we just want to have lots of storage. So we'll put a double chest there. We need to bring in an anvil because anvils are used in the process of enchanting, like that. And while we're here, we may as well lob in some furnace. Oh, that's not a furnace. There, just to give us a more complete area. That's quite good. So we've got anvilage, we've got brewage, we've got enchantage, and we've got furnaceage with plenty of storage. Yeah, you go, you saw where I was going there, didn't you? Brilliant. And then we're going to carry on by creating the more permanent light system all around the ground floor. So on the same level, so as it doesn't look odd, we're going to come around there, 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 and there. And we've got this huge area underneath here, so we're going to put the glowstone under there. We're just going to put a trapdoor there, and that works fine. It's a bit of a shame that you can't cover that bit up, but that's all right. You know what? I will live with it. We're going to put glowstone in this corner. There, there, and there. We can get rid of that glowstone because we're going to put glowstone in this corner. There and there. And in the opposite corner. There and there. And then we can also put another bit, I think, there would be nice. So as it's a little bit in, doesn't kind of overlap the edge and push itself up above there. There. Get rid of that glowstone, and then equally we can come around this side with that glowstone there. On this one we can put a cap on it, and then we match that on exactly the other side in the same spot, which is there. So that matches up like that. And then here, we've got this really kind of strange, it's not really strange, I suppose, but a slot that you can't reach when you're up here. So, for example, if I put that there, I don't think you can reach it, or can you? Oh, you can! Brilliant! Well, I now know what to do with that then. We're going to put a row of furnaces in there because you can reach it perfectly. Oh, that's the result. I didn't think you could actually reach that. I'm very happy. That is a happy avo. We're just going to put a row of glowstone in there. Like that, there, 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 and there. And that lights that up really nicely. We want similarly upstairs, because I think now we've got enough light downstairs now to cover us and sort us out. I want to come upstairs, do some more lighting up here, and also place a lot more bits and pieces so it is a more functional upper area. So let's crack on with that, and I'll be back when I'm done. So I think we've pretty much finished the inside. We've got what we had before, loads of lighting. It looks really kind of gothic and grand on the inside of that. And we've got all of our crafting and enchanting area there. Then I couldn't help myself. I made myself a little kitchen with a working hob, whatever that ever so nice. And then here we've got a little seating area with some more pictures. I just thought it looked nice. I couldn't help myself. Aesthetic always grabs me. What can I tell you? We've got a seating area by that gable window with linear lighting. We've got our sleeping area. Our precious ender chest is right there. Loads of storage by using chest, trap chest, chest going along the outside. So we can put the chest next to each other. Storage, more furnaceage, a little bit of armorage. And then coming this side, this is the true crafting area with plenty of seating, lots of storage, and all of our stored tools. Although, diamond hoe, am I mad? Never, ever, ever waste your diamonds on a hoe. Coming around this way. What we've got to do now, however, is we need to do more on the outside, because right now, the outside just ain't cutting it. The inside's looking good. The outside needs some work. So we're going to do that right now. We've given ourselves a bit of a wildlife garden, although we have got some proper crops growing in there and some tomato plants that are doing a really good impression of roses. Or are they roses doing a really good impression of tomato plants? No one will know. Well, I will, because there are clearly roses. Anyway, stop talking. We have got, I think, quite a nice little setup here. We've put ourselves a little chimney on the roof as well. It's starting to look really, really good. I'm very happy with it, and that is where we are going to finish it off. We've put some trees in, and I think that would be a really nice place to live. So that is one fairly rustic, but a little bit stony house that I think looks really, really good in this landscape. You've got all the trees around it. You've got a nice outside and the inside works really, really well too. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed it, please do make sure you slap that like button for me. I'd love to see you smacking it right on the nose and we'll see whether or not you want us to keep doing these sorts of videos. Also, if you've not done it already, please do hit that subscribe button. It'd be great to see you in my sub club. I look forward to seeing you in another video. You take it easy now. Bye.